is Singapore's top ally. This pink dot, I'm gonna teach you the alphabet.
Nobody asked. Nobody asked.
Literally nobody asked it.
A is for anyhow only. Can we stop anyhow assuming people's pronouns? Can we just ask someone what they want to be referred to as? It's just like how Lady Gaga tells us that her name is Lady Gaga, then we all just call her Lady Gaga, no questions asked. Same logic lah. B is for beautiful. So we all know that beauty standards are like made up, right? And you don't have to look a certain way to be beautiful.
You are beautiful, you are beautiful.
But I am damn beautiful. C is for coming out. So in the past year, some really iconic celebrities publicly came out. Right here in Singapore, I just want to shout out everyone who might have recently come out as well. In case you haven't and you're struggling to, just know that you always have a community that's ready to love and accept you for everything that you are. D is for discrimination. Unfortunately, still exists all around us. E is for equality. Excuse me, how to be an equal society when so many policies still work against the LGBTQ plus community? F is for freedom to love. Hello. When it comes to sexual orientation, everybody should be allowed to love whoever they want, okay? The only gay I don't love is tau gay. G is for gay. Some people still want to use the word gay as a slur. Excuse me, it's not gay if I'm crying because I watch Lilo and Stitch. I'm just crying because I have a soul. H is for human rights. Please don't forget, gay rights, lesbian rights, trans rights are all human rights. I is for intersectionality. It's how your gender or sexual orientation intersects with your class, race, religion, physical ability, and the list goes on. If your advocacy doesn't have room for those who are the most vulnerable based off these intersectionalities, then we must ask, what kind of advocacy is this, huh? J is for justice. Now that the constitutional challenge is being decided in the courts, let's hope for justice to be upheld. K is for... Okay, time to check out all these really important resources and avenues that you see on screen right now. L is for the legal guidebook for LGBT couples and families in Singapore. So this is available as an ebook online on this website, so check it out and be empowered with the information to protect yourselves under the law. M is for MediaCorp, with their constant misrepresentation of minority groups. So this character was a pedophile who molested teenage boys and also had an STD. Come on lah, if you're not gonna be inclusive with your content or at least represent the community respectfully, then all I gotta say is N is for no thank you. The least that non-members of the LGBTQ plus community can do is to be an ally. And I don't mean some weird tokenistic crap like,
I have gay friends.
I mean actually be inclusive and respectful in your everyday lives. Having a gay best friend is not an aesthetic. O is for, oi, stare was stare. How come people so rude when members of the LGBTQ plus community show any form of physical affection to their partners in public, but then suddenly got double standard? They got tsikope on the train, nobody say anything. P is for pretty please. Come, let me show you a couple of cute outfits I would have worn to Hong Lim Park if this year's Pink Dot was a physical event. Q is for Queer Trivia Night. Excuse me, why you haven't taken part yet? So I host Queer Trivia Night with Proud and the Katong Queers, and it's always super fun. Here are details for the next one. I will see you there. R is for Repeal 3778. Hello. What time already? My country already 160 on the World Press Freedom Index, and then now they also want to be last to repeal 377A and decriminalize gay sex, is it? S is for small. Remember the uncle who not happy with the pride flag at the store? This one not small thing, okay? This one big thing. Shout out to all the brands, stores, and public figures who aren't afraid to just speak up for what you believe in. T is for the transgender student incident. Excuse me, can MOE focus on things that they are supposed to, like having an inclusive education system and teaching people life skills and things like compassion? U is for the United Nations Universal Periodic Review. On 12th of May, Singapore's head of delegation mentioned that the government does not tolerate discrimination and harassment against the LGBT community. They even cited Pink Dot as an example that the LGBTQ community is not discriminated. Talk so much, then every year pre-COVID already make it so difficult for Pink Dot to even exist. And then now you want to say, do not tolerate discrimination. V is for valued members of society. Our beloved Prime Minister has been pushing for foreign talent and even said that members of the LGBT community were seen as valued members of society. Aww, so sweet! Okay, now that you value them so much, how about you legalize gay marriage? W is for Wee-san. I miss Wee-san so much. So just so y'all know, he's been in the army since last November. Shout out all members of the LGBTQ plus community who are serving the nation right now. I hope it's not as painfully straight as the A Boys to Men movies. X is for Xie-xie. Thank you to the team who fought tirelessly to challenge Section 377A. Y is for you, for attending Pink Dot 13 and for making it this far into this video. Z is for Z-Z-Z. Bye-bye. I go sleep liao. Thank you for watching this video and happy Pink Dot.